Now make yourself useful. And the first part of useful is not driving me insane with your constant complaining.
Say whatever you damn well please, but I tell you, if I don't get out of here soon, I'm gonna kill somebody.
And if you don't stop hissing at me, I'm gonna kill you.
You come near me?
What is wrong with you two?
I ain't chopping vegetables for a living.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam. Was there insufficient feathers in your pillow?
I ain't lazy, Mr. Morgan. I'll work, but not this.
Well, I ain't cooking work.
My husband and I, we shared the work. All of it. I was out in the fields. I can hunt, carry a knife, or use a gun. But I tell you, you keep me here, I'll skin this fat old coot and serve him for dinner.
Watch your damn mouth, you crazy goddamn fishwife.
Enough, both of you. Well, come with me then. You want to head out there, run with the men? So be it. But we do more than just hunting. We're hunted. And them things hunting us, well, they got guns of their own.
I ain't afraid of dying.
Good. You need anything, Mr. Pearson? Maybe me and Miss Zed are gonna take a little ride.
Yeah, sure. Here's my list, and can you post this letter for me while you're there?
Sure. Come on, Princess. Are you coming with me then, woman?
So I've graduated from chopping vegetables to shopping?
Shut your goddamn mouth. You cool down then yet?
I guess. I ain't no scullion, and I sure as hell ain't taking orders from that sweating halfwit.
I guess we all gotta do our share, Princess.
Where's that letter?
Are you reading his mail now?
Oh, robbing and killing's okay, but letter reading's where we draw the line.
Mm-hmm. Here.
Dear Aunt Kathy.
You are something else.
I haven't heard from you in some time, so I pray to the Lord above that your health has not deteriorated further. Blah, blah, blah. It's boring. Ooh. Wait a sec. Listen to this. Since we last corresponded, I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself. Before you ask, I am still yet to take a wife, but I can assure you it's not for a lack of suitors. You ever actually even talk to a woman he ain't paid for?
Oh, look, we're all hiding behind something.
And what's this? Return to Tacitus Kilgore.
Oh, that's Dutch's idea. All mail to be sent to the same alias. Whatever we set up somewhere new, Strauss, he heads into town. Tells him to start expecting mail from a Tacitus Kilgore, whatever they changed it to. Here, give me that back. We got work to do. Okay, here we are.
So, what's the plan? I shoot the shopkeeper while you...
No! You insane?
I thought we was outlaws.
Outlaws, not idiots. We rob fools that rob other people. These people, they're just trying to get by. So you head on in there and you buy us some food to eat. No guns.
You sure?
This time, there'll be time for killing soon enough.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna go check the mail. Nothing exciting.
Mister?
Yes, I would like to post a letter.
All right. Okay, no trouble.
Thank you.
Bye now.
Oh, dear.
Why on earth are you doing this?
Don't act like that.
Well, I hope that's out of your system.
Well, hello.
I think this is everything.
Thanks. Here, take that for yourself, okay?
Thanks.
We'll give it back then. Jesus. I didn't ask for his goddamn help.
Why don't you drive?
Okay.
Come on, lady, get a move on.
I like Sadie, not lady.
I know. So, you get everything?
I think so.
And some new clothes, I see.
Don't start. I can wear what I damn well want. Like I told you, my husband and I shared all the work. I wasn't some little wife with a flower in her hair baking cherry pies all day.
Yeah, I don't doubt that. You sure look the part now. Won't be long before you're smoking cigars and playing the harmonica.
I'll have you know, I used to love playing the harmonica before. Well, my house and everything I own got burned to the ground.
I know. I'm real sorry about what you, you know. Maybe I'll keep my eye out for another one.
I don't want no pity. Just treat me equal and know. Nobody's taking nothing from me ever again.
Mm-hmm. Just don't kill the camp cook.
Hey there!
Hey.
What you folks up to?
Just heading home.
You're in Lemoyne Raider country.
Keep it cool, Steve.
You need to pay a toll to pass through here.
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so? How about you pull over right now?
Pull over?
That's what I said.
Hey, how's about this?
Go, go, go!
Get moving now! Come on! What the hell was that?
They was gonna rob us. Yeah!
New pair of pants? Think you're landing rickets?
Oh, shit! I'm gonna run this son of a bitch down!
See some action, lady. Now you've got your wish.
You ain't messing with no Sunday soldier, boy.
You okay there, Sadie?
Cool. Oh. You think I can't handle these fools?
We're gonna make one.
Get behind something. Told you I could shoot a gun, didn't I?
I don't remember asking you to prove it.
There, see? Not many still standing now. Only one fan goddamn tall is you, sons of bitches!
Lady, you are enjoying this far too much.
Ah, damn it! Yeah, you run, you goddamn coward!
I think we're good here, Arthur.
I'm shooting. All right, I'll drive us back.
No, pass those reins here.
Why?
Because you've caused enough trouble already.
I'm fine. We showed those bastards, huh?
Remind me not to get on your bad side.
And they was clearly planning to bushwhack us.
You did good. But that's a lot of mess to make near camp. Hope it don't bring anyone sniffing around.
Are you gonna tell Dutch?
Maybe. If he asks. But maybe not.
Hey, you want me to drive? So who did they say they were? Lemoyne Raiders?
Yeah, something like that. Who knows? Anyway, don't you go ribbing Pearson about that letter.
How dare you? I wouldn't dream of it.
Right, you wouldn't.
I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself.
I won't be giving you no mail to post Anytime soon, that's for sure.
I just want to peek in that journal of yours. The mind boggles.
Not a chance.
You didn't get yourself killed then, Miss Adler.
Not quite.
Well, I'd like to say I missed your refined conversations, but I'd be lying.
I enjoyed myself out there.
Yes, Mrs. Adler did okay.
At shopping?
Yes, at shopping.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
Don't mention it. I would ride with you again, Mrs. Adler, if you will ride with me.
Maybe. If you prove you can handle yourself.
Well, they say I lack finesse, but I ain't afraid of gun smoke.
We got this, Arthur. You've already done me a big favor today. Okay, Miss High and Mighty. And nice pants, by the way.
Oh, shut up.
Arthur. Lovely morning, ain't it?
So, what do you think of this place?
Not bad. Nice to be by the water.
Yeah, it'll do for now. Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Take care, Arthur.
We're stuck in the ship now, Mr. Morgan. In the ship. We're drowning in mud.
For a man of the cloth, you have quite a way with words.
Words are the very least of my problems. The very least.
I'm sure.
How are you?
Alive. And you?
Fine. Let me ask you a question. If I was to kill Miss Grimshaw, would Dutch be mad?
I think, as a general rule, Dutch likes to avoid murder within the camp. I mean, there was that one time, but he was a traitor. But Miss Grimshaw, well, Dutch has a soft spot for her.
I thought as much. Was she always like this?
I ain't quite old enough to know.
No, of course. So as long as you've known her?
She's always liked her swill of vinegar.
I'd like to give her a swig of arsenic.
Well, just do it discreetly.
I will. You fancy a game of dominoes?
Sure, why not?
If I'm playing with you, she'll leave me alone.
Can't believe the dominoes survived Blackwater, but my necklace didn't.
Oh, yeah. I thought something looked different.
Well, I stole that one. I'm sure I can steal another easy enough.
I'll keep my eye out for you, too.
guess I kind of feel bad for you. Well, whoops for you. You can't just leave in the middle of a game. Hey, Bill.
Hi, Tilly. Hello. Oh.
Hell, someone showed up. What you looking at? March along.
Good, calm down.
It's best that you be on
Sorry.
Your...
No, I'll stop messing with you now.
This is all your... Anybody! Please, help me! What? Why are you doing this?
This is...
Rotten hell! Untie me now!
Come on, man.
What was that?
Ah!
Hey, mister. Remember me? Come on over.
How you doing today? Well, you see this here? American ginseng. Take a feller from not too bad to hearty as buck in no time. Really something. Yep, you don't find this every day. Dose this in your medicine, give it some zip. Believe me.
Whatever you're selling, I ain't buying.
Anyway, I ain't gonna use all of this, so feel free to help yourself to whatever's left. You take care now.
Thanks. Be well, friend. Yep. Excuse me.
What's happening?
You know, can't even be bothered with this.
Sure, anyway.
Hey there, partner.
Go to hell.
Boom! Hey there.
Can I help you?
Just taking a look.
We're with the Appleseed Timber Company. Head foreman. We're still getting started on this site, but we should have some fine Big Valley lumber for sale very soon if you're interested.
I'll keep that in mind.
We should be further along by now, but what can you do? Look at these dolts. There's not a brain between them. Listen. You got any supplies for sale? Food? Medicine? I'm starting to run low. I can't spare anyone to go into town, not the way things are going. I'd be happy to pay premium for them. Appreciate it. That should help keep us going.
I'm leaving. Don't work too hard.
There ain't much danger of that with this bunch, my friend.
Yeah.
Thank you. Hey, Arthur. Good to see you.
Why? You want rescuing again, dear?
No. I got a plan to make it up to you.
A plan like the Blackwater Ferry job, or like you going off scouting and ending up in jail?
Dutch said you was a big shadow cast by a tiny tree.
I don't even know what that means.
I thought you was a tough boy. Not one of those gentlemen trying to protect his riding clothes.
Well, I just know whenever things get real, you turn yellow and lose your head.
Yellow?
Sure seems that way.
So I guess you won't be riding with me to rob the banking coach comes about this time in the Strawberry. I heard one of the O'Driscoll boys yapping about it while I was inside.
You and me? Do a robbery?
That's what I said, didn't I?
After you.
Come on. I know an overlook where we can watch for them coming in.
What are you doing anyway, camping out here like some crazy hermit?
Can't exactly stay in town now, can I? Like I told you, I ain't going back to Dodge without a peace offering.
So what's the deal with this coach?
What do you mean? Comes through about this time every day, like I said, the end.
I mean, how many men? Guns? Riders?
Nothing serious. It'll be fine.
I heard the bank's been hiring every trigger man they can get of late. The meaner, the better.
You worry too much.
Forgive me if I ain't wholly faithful in something an old O'Driscoll told you when you was half drunk in a jail cell.
He kept yapping about it, saying how they've been hitting it on the regular. That's a good lead in my book.
Damn, O'Driscolls are everywhere now.
Bastards got a hold of most of Big Valley. Heard they took over some big ranch north of here.
How the hell you and Lenny end up down here anyway?
Oh, you know how it is? Few loose ends. Drink here, drink there.
What loose ends?
Nothing that needs to concern you. I always pay my share.
It concerns me when you put us in danger and we don't realize till it's too late. Like that move you pulled in Strawberry, making me kill half the town just for your precious guns.
Precious they are. You need to roll a little looser, Morgan.
Looser? I've seen you come full on. More than once now, and you only been running with us a few months.
Are we gonna rob this coach or bicker about it? What's done is done.
Guess we're robbing it.
Then let's do it. On this ridge.
Whoa!
They should be here in a little bit. Hold tight.
Which way will they be coming in?
Should be from over there. We need to hit them fast before they get into town.
Just don't lose your head this time.
Of course, tough guy. They should be here any minute. Look, here they are. Right on time. Get covered up. Come on! Ride! Hiya!
Come on.
See? I told you this would be fun, Morgan.
This is fun for you.
Bert, get up. I'll drive. No need to keep your face covered now.
It's just you and me, sweetheart. I'll give it to them. They put up half a fight, at least.
Yeah! Baylock! Come on, boy!
Here. Fine new rifle, too. Here you go, Arthur. From me to you. That's more your style than mine.
What did I tell you?
Like licking butter off a knife.
Something like that. You don't want to just break it open here, be done with it?
Could be more than we can carry. And there might be a second crew of riders tailing.
All right, then.
Not to mention, we ride back in with a big take, new wagon to boot. Dutch can't say we ain't pulling our weight no more, can he?
I ain't sure I trust this new act of yours one bit.
Listen. I know we got off on the wrong foot,
but I got no beef with you.
I reckon we're a lot alike, you and me.
Now, hold up there.
Dutch knows I'm a feller that gets things done, same as you.
Gets things done? You'd be wearing a California collar now if I hadn't broken you out of jail.
And I have expressed my gratitude, have I not?
Shit! Now we're being robbed! Get across the river!
What the hell?
Come on, Arthur, get out of there! You dumb bastards!
You okay?
I think so. Just keep your head down.
Let's finish.
Job I do with you ends in a pile of dead bodies.
Since when did you have a problem killing O'Driscoll's?
You've got a point.
It clearly ain't going nowhere now. You know, we should really pick up a lock breaker one of these days. Save ourselves some bullets.
Yeah, because saving bullets is such a concern of yours.
Will you? Let's take what we can and get the hell out of here.
That lock should shoot off easy enough.
I'll give you the honors.
That should do it.
Come on, let's see if all this was worth it.
All I see is you, me, a river full of dead O'Driscolls, and a lockbox. I'd say we're golden here, Morgan. Look at that.
Hey.
What's the cut here?
It's good. Just make sure the gang gets its piece.
Yeah, yeah. Like I said, big shadow, tiny tree.
And like I said, that still don't mean nothing. Get out of here. Go see Dutch. Make sure you ain't followed.
I know, boss. I know. It's been fun.
Okay, fella.
Twisted my ankle something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Yeah, sure. Hop on.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. You know Emerald Ranch? Mind taking me there?
Sure.
Glad I ran into you. Huh. I raised that horse, you know. Raised it since it was just a foal.
Losing a horse is hard. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah. That horse did right by me. Better than my husband, truth be told. That fool. Always complaining. But does he do something about it? Man barely lifts his hand to wave the flies away. Aside from to lift a drink, of course. Marriage, for me, has been nothing but trouble. But Biscuit? He was a fine animal. Loyal. Smart. Brave. Didn't take no guff. Not from no one. Had one of them mountain boys pull a gun on me once. I was riding up near the Dakota and had stopped by a nice warm patch. Must have dozed off, but I wake up and find some nasty piece of work pointing a rusty shotgun straight at me. Well, he gets wheezing on, and I must have made some sort of noise, because the next thing I know, Biscuit had nipped his ear clean off. Kicked his hide, too, as he was hollering away. Didn't think a man could run so fast.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, had a good laugh on that one. I tell the husband, what does he do? Should have never gone over there, honey, he says. Gee, thanks.
So, you live at Emerald Ranch, then? Yeah.
For the time being. I was looking for work. They was looking for some help with the gardens. If I waited any longer for my husband to put food on the table, I'd have died of starvation. I'll be moving on soon, though. Emerald Ranch, well, it's a strange place. Oh, we're getting close now.
How you doing?
Here we go. This is great. This was kind of you, mister. Please, take this as my way of thanking you. Appreciate it. What a lousy day.
Don't be shy, partner. No such thing as a stranger here.
Hello, mister.
Well, you look like you need to take a load off.
Well, ain't this a rare... treat. Why didn't you tell me we had guests coming? I'd have fixed myself up nice.
Oh, now you know you look... perfect, princess.
I ain't no guest, miss. I'm just passing through.
Oh, nonsense. Well, come on in. Rest a while. And we got food on the stove and a bottle of the good stuff we've been saving.
It's decided, then. I'm gonna go freshen up.
I appreciate the offer, but I best be on my way.
Oh, come on now. How you gonna turn down a hot meal and good company? I'll go open that bottle.
Hey, there he is. Come on in. Come on.
This is very kind of you.
Don't sweat it, partner. The pleasure's all ours. I hope she ain't primping for hours up there. We'll never eat. Go check on her, will you?
Hungry, ain't you?
I didn't mean to intrude, miss.
It's all right. Looking ain't a crime. You go on and have a seat at the table. I'll be down in a minute.
He just asked me to check on you, that's all.
Oh, you don't need to make any excuses. No, sirree.
And there was me thinking you were the bashful type. You rascal. I'll be right down, I promise. This ain't over. Just a minute.
She'll, be down in just a minute.
Woohoo! That is what I like to hear. Hey, now pull up a chair, partner. Oh, hey!
Hey!
Ain't this just about perfect? One of them moments you wish could last forever.
Well, like I said, I can't stay for long.
Then look at us. Like a couple of old friends. Ah. It's a short life, but a merry one.
Here we are, all the fixings. I hope you boys left some room in your trousers.
Mmm, that smells delicious. The food don't smell too bad, neither.
Oh, stop it, you! How do you like it?
Mmm, it's good. Different. That meat is so tender. You know what? This place used to be a pig farm when we was kids. Before we lost our ma and pa. Horrible business.
Horrible.
But we still got each other, ain't that right, honey pie?
And we still know how to have a hog killing time.
Here, that's for you.
Yeah.
There.
Yeah. Where are my manners? Drinks.
Yeah, I could definitely use a drink.
That stuff will put hair on your chest.
Oh, I doubt he needs that. Let's loosen you up some more. Come on, honey.
What the hell is that?
That's an old Aberdeen home recipe. That one right there is in 1894.
Feels like someone's stabbing me in the head.
Come on, I thought I had a man here, not a boy. One more, and you and I both will go upstairs and have a lie down.
Ah, what the hell?
Oh, about time. I'd take whatever cash he has on and put behind Mama.
Got some respect. Whoa. Now, I'm just gonna check your pockets.
I'm gonna bleed you dry! Where are you taking me? Put me down.
sick sons of bitches. Thank you.
Let's go, boy. Let's go. Coming with me. madam.
You, my friend, what do you think about women's suffrage?
Women voting? Sure, why not?
Oh, thank you, sir. You are a true progressive.
Anyone dumb enough to want to vote, I say go for it.
Oh, a cynic. How dull for you. I do hope you grow out of it, young man. It's so unappealing.
Unappealing is what I do best. Hi there. Hey, mind your step.
Sorry, mister. My mistake.
Please, no!
Oh, you bastard!
Or hey, I think that fella might have just picked your pocket.
That's left me a little...
What's your problem? I didn't do nothing.
I only stock the best in my shop. Buy from me, and you'll never be disappointed. I stand behind everything I sell in this place, so you can purchase with confidence. I only stock the best in my shop. Buy from me, and you'll never be disappointed. I stand behind everything I sell in this place, so you can purchase with confidence. I only stock the best in my shop. Buy from me, and you'll never be disappointed. I stand behind everything I sell in this place, so you can purchase with confidence.
I remember when men settled arguments with their pistols by the dueling oaths. Now, Edouard will barely raise his voice.
Oh, my man, if I had a dollar for every time somebody said to me, haven't I met you somewhere else? I only stock the best in my shop. Buy from me, and you'll never be disappointed. Let me know what I can do to help you leave here feeling good and looking great. I stand behind everything I sell in this place, so you can purchase with confidence.
At least the sun is shining.
Lucky for me, ladies don't.
I only stock the best in my shop. Buy from me, and you'll never be disappointed. I get all sorts walking into this establishment, but they all end up looking better when they walk out. I stand behind everything I sell in this place, so you can purchase with confidence. People around here come in just for those. Please, peruse at your leisure. I carry only the finest items. I only stock the best in my shop. Buy from me, and you'll never be disappointed. We have styles for all persuasions, but I'm sure you'll look good in anything you choose. I stand behind everything I sell in this place, so you can purchase with confidence. All right then, but if there was anything in there that caught your eye, it'll be right here waiting for you.
What you get when you cross me? Another soul going down to hell.
What happened? Looks like he's worse for wear.
Okay, off you go then.
Good evening.
Sometimes a quiet night is what you need. Enjoy your evening alone.
What can I do for you?
Oh, a whiskey.
Please! Gentlemen, you're embarrassing yourselves. You're not even good drunks.
Bonsoir, monsieur.
Nice to see another feller in here who ain't born with a silver spoon in his mouth. Don't know why I still come in here, to be honest. Maybe because I can. I'll never be one of those people, but, you know, sometimes we all like to kid Bonsoir. Ourselves. Maybe Salut. We're better than we ain't. Bonsoir, not that any of these fancy fools Bonsoir. Are any better. I don't know. I'm sorry, mister. Maybe I had a couple too many.
Boring. All of you. You're all boring. You should be ashamed of yourselves. Not an interesting mind or a nasty habit among the lot of you. Place used to be sophisticated. Stories I heard would make a devil flush.
Good evening.
Not anymore. Devil's gone elsewhere.
What's
we're
your step?
With the choir masters.
I shouldn't.
And not the fun kind.
For Christ's sake.
Yes, a bit tight around here.
Can I get a room for tonight, please?
Okay, room's all set. Just head upstairs when you're ready.
Hey, y'all.
Hey, mister.
Hello.
Motley bunch of fellas around here. Just watch yourself, all right?
See you soon.
Hmm. Just right here, think.
No, you know nothing. Bunch of ignorami. That's plural
I've
for
noticed
ignoramus.
You're following me.
Latin, like honeylingus. False at left. I have an education. Daddy hired a wonderful tutor. Poor fellow. Fell in love with my mother. Hanged himself. They say hang.
Evening to you.
Evening to you, mister.
You seem in good spirits, miss. All the best to you.
Y'all take care now. Ain't you a sweet boy?
Hello.
You don't want to sleep alone now, do you?
Decent town you got here. All the best now.
I trust everything is well.
Ma'am?
All right, maybe later then.
Hello, ladies.
Howdy, big boy.
Bonjour, monsieur.
This is turning into one of them days.
Oh?
Anyway, all the best to you.
Au revoir.
If you can't treat people with respect, what's the point, I say?
How about that?
Had to buy myself a Derringer for walking about.
Warner?
You can never be too
careful. Why, hello.
Hope I didn't offend you earlier.
Okay, but you made me sad, honey.
Just not the right night.
So long now.
I hear young Pushhair's son does not have his father's eyes.
Well, ain't that the damn...
How's the crowd tonight? Hungry?
Nice to see you, ladies.
Hello there, mister. Sweetheart.
Morning to you.
Bonjour, monsieur.
And hello again.
Hello, good looking.
We have to stop meeting like this.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll leave you to it.
See you soon.
Thanks for your assistance.
I'm not one to gossip, but I fear, bro.
Pardon me.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, Hardy Hall.
Good morning.
Hello. Looking for a trim?
Hey. Morning, Dad.
So, what do you need?
Thank you. Yeah, that looks good.
So you're getting along okay?
Well, that's a bit better.
I guess we're all done here.
Thanks, partner.
Later, gonna hold my...
What?
Praise God, the small...
Young lady ridiculed your disfigurement.
Disfigurement?
You murdered her in cold blood. For your awful vanity and pride, you will pay.
You'll pay her,
right?
At least you remember me, friend. As you live.
Help me out.
Any last words before the noose?
That ugly bitch deserved what she got.
She deserved it.
Move next time.
Enough! Pull. Abhorrent behavior will not stand in this country. Justice won this battle, but the war is far from over. Heed these words.
This must be your first time. Welcome.
So, friend, can you take my photograph, please?
No, no way.
Oh, hell.
Let us not waste too much creative energy on the background, hmm? Great. The Congo. Only stupid people will believe you have been there. You know, if you were really in a bordello, you would be wearing less. Ah, Vesuvius. Mount Vesuvius, for your portrait. Yes. Me, something called. Give me a pause and don't be shy.
Hope it ain't as bad as I fear.
Hey, do not point the thing at me.
You know, forget about it.
Yes, good. You can return when you learn how to act.
Welcome, sir. Come in and have a browse. Take a look at our catalog. Let me know if you want to get a feel for any of them.
Now, let me see.
No problem. You come back to it any time. You ever thought about getting some enhancements for that gun? Would you consider some of our gun improvements? Do you have enough ammunition for that thing? Would you be interested in me changing some of the parts at all? I can do some nice ornate engraving on there, if you like. Good price. This town can be dangerous after dark. Always go armed. I have some better quality components if you're looking for the best. Looks like you've been taking good care of that gun. I could add some rifling into the barrel if you want. Makes it much more accurate.
That's great.
That'll give you a real edge.
I'm all right.
If the Italians keep taking from me, I don't know how much longer I will be able to stay open. Man got shot right there on Courtney Street. Around here, you carry a gun. Size is sharper. I like it. Did you know a rifle barrel adds noticeable accuracy? We can do that to this model for a great price. I could add some rifling into the barrel if you want. Makes it much more accurate. That's a fine firearm. We also offer an engraving service in case you are interested.
That should be good. Thank you. Really.
Buenos dias.
Don't make any dumb
moves. Whoa, there's got to be another way.
Hey, I didn't want to start a fight anyway.
What's going on? Is there a party I wasn't invited to?
Nothing to worry about. I'll be on my way.
Why don't you leave now before this gets any worse for you?
Of course. No problems here.
Thank you.
Hey, you there! Can I have a word?
Not gonna fall for that.
Oh, no, you don't.
You got a new revolver, did you?
So, what do you think of this place?
Seems fine for now.
Save my hide not once, but twice.
What you want, Micah?
Nothing. Just saying thank you, brother. I can call you brother, can't I?
I think I like you even less when you're friendly.
You're the first person ever told me that.
Why don't you come here and sit down?
I ain't no O'Driscoll. I swear I proved myself.
All right, will you take it easy?
Mr. Morgan!
You're a pathetic man, John Marston!
Don't I know it?
You wanna have a drink?
Oh, no thank you, sir.
Hey, hi there, Arthur!
Found this. You said you lost yours.
Oh, it's beautiful. Thank you. Here, please take this. It's the least I can do.
I can't right
hey,
now.
Mary Beth.
Sure,
hi there.
I gotta go help with the horses. Sorry. Excuse me.
With the horses? Wait a minute. Come on,
Mr. Morgan.
Here.
Mr. Morgan.
Come on back here.
Yes, Reverend.
Do you think the Pinkertons are finally gonna kill us?
Perhaps.
I'm so worried.
Hi, Arthur.
Next time we run an errand together, remind me to pack more bullets.
Come on, Arthur. Don't
How you doing, old friend?
Fine.
It's funny, us ending up down here. My daddy died in a field in Pennsylvania, fighting this lot. I ever tell you that?
Many times.
I see I'm boring you, Arthur.
Worrying me. We lost men back there.
We have lofty goals, Arthur. We're trying to reform society to a kinder, truer, better way. Now, of course, there's gonna be casualties.
We're thieves. In a world that don't want us no more.
We are dreamers in an ever duller world of facts. Now, I'll give you that, but come on. We got the day. It's nice out. old Jose says that there's a creek around here. I reckon it's full of fish. Show us this crick you've been pissing in.
Hey, you don't look too rosy, old friend. I thought this warmer weather would...
My days are looking good along over, Dutch.
Always dream of crushing and bubble bursting, you. Come on, Hosea. Let's go fishing.
All right, gentlemen. Let me show you how it's done.
Fish here. There's a whole lake of them.
Because I need to get out for a bit. Me and the old guard. Before any of them back there, oh, there was us.
The curious couple and their unruly son.
It feels good here. You did well finding that spot, Arthur.
More Charles than me.
It's like I can breathe again, thick and soupy as this air is. Might even do your whistling pipes some good, Hosea.
I was once in this country with Bessie. Ah, feels like a lifetime ago.
It was a lifetime ago. But what a life we have lived, how well we have fought, especially both of you.
I hope so.
But now, when things are desperate, we have to stick with the plan. Make enough money, then find somewhere where nobody will find us. But we don't have to hide.
Like where?
I got some ideas hatching, but I need you with me, not against me. Both of you.
Of course.
Still, we do need money. So keep a low profile, especially in the local town. After Valentine, I want everyone on best behavior here. No trouble. But start turning over the soil and the rocks. See what turns up.
Dutch, we've got to be discreet.
Imagine what a slew of rich simpletons there must be down here. Oh, this is perfect for you, Hosea. You'll be able to play them like a fiddle.
Nothing would give me greater pleasure, but...
No buts. Not today. We fish and we enjoy the day. Looks like law up ahead. Play it cool. Easy.
Hello, gentlemen. Well, look what the cat drug in.
Well, well, look
I
who it is.
I've gotten myself in a spot of bother.
Quiet back there.
Let's see if we can't sort this out. How are you, boys?
Fine.
This is quite some country you have here.
We like it well enough.
Hoagie McIntosh, at your service.
Lee Gray, this is my deputy Archibald McGregor.
It is good to meet you.
You a Scot?
Partly. The best part.
Of course.
Now, tell me, sir, what did the silly, fancy fop back there do? Nothing too terrible, I trust.
He was accused of running a gold mining investment scam.
Oh, no. I'm sure he wasn't. He is a magician. I know him. He's a fool. But he is not a bad fellow. Now, can we just...
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Shit! The Anderson boys! I can't have more scandal!
Well, allow us to help, my friend. Arthur!
Chase wanted man.
And take Archibald with you.
Just what I signed up for. Come on, big guy.
Perhaps we can discuss the foolish magician.
Stay with that train.
Don't let them get away. Keep your guns holstered. We need them Anderson boys alive.
Hurry up, David!
Come on, hurry!
All right.
Come on, we're losing them.
Will you relax? We're not losing them.
Faster, come on. What's your name, sir?
Arthur Callahan.
Faster, Mr. Callahan, please. My neck is on the line here.
I get it. I'm doing my best. Looks like the son of a bitch is gonna make it. You sure I can't just shoot him?
No. Did I not say that?
You've said plenty.
What are you waiting for? I'm right here!
Idiot. Now get after the others. Come on. The train is slowing down to go through the station. Now's our chance. Get to the side of the train. Yeah. Get in closer. Get alongside that flat carriage. You think you can jump on there?
Me? Why me?
Because you ride like my grandmother.
You are something else. You cop bastards. I didn't do nothing. I think he's dead. I think I won the fight. Oh, just about.
Bring him out here.
Deputy?
Sounded like quite a commotion. Is that him?
I sincerely hope so.
Old Anders Anderson.
So what now?
Take him in. Come on. A fine job. Well done. And a pat on the back for me for stopping the train. Load Anders onto the back of your horse there, and we'll take him to Sheriff Gray. There you go. You are a natural. All right, let's take him in. Follow me.
What about the others?
Oh, we'll round them up. Anders back there is the brains of the operation, and that's really saying something.
You're the boss.
That was mighty impressive, sir. I have to admit. I'd hazard a guess you've served the law yourself at some point.
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that.
Are you familiar with the area here?
No, not really.
On your right here, these tobacco fields? This is part of Callaghan Hall, big estate belonging to the Gray family.
Looks bone dry.
Yes, we are in dire need of some rain round here, let me tell you. The Grays have lived in Callaghan Hall for generations. fine people. My family's been working for them for years. Sheriff Gray's the one I know best, of course, but they own half the businesses in town.
Which town?
Rhodes, sir. You don't know it? Where we're headed right now ain't what it was before the war, but it has its charms. I'm sure you already know of the Braithwaites.
Like I said, just got down here.
Another big family in these parts. They have an estate west of here. Awful people, truly awful. They've been fighting with the Greys for as long as I can remember.
Sounds like quite the place you got here.
We're gonna bear left here. Here we are. Welcome to Rhodes. Up there on your left is the Rhodes Parlor House. Very reputable saloon owned by the Gray family. We also have a general store, gunsmith, post office, train station, of course.
What more do you need?
Oh, good. They're back. And that's your friend, right?
Yep.
Okay, we're gonna stop just ahead on the right, outside the sheriff's office. Can you grab Anders off your horse and carry him in for me? Come on, partner, before he wakes up. Carry him over, then.
Hey, fellas.
Mr. Gray! We got him.
Very good.
I told you Arthur would deliver. Man has a passion for justice.
That's wonderful.
So, about my friend here?
Your idiot friend is free to go. But no more trouble from you, partner.
I promise you, this was all just a big misunderstanding. However, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I'll pretend to appreciate that. Mr. McIntosh, it has been a real pleasure. The mostly good citizens of Rhodes, we welcome you.
Well, we're just honored to be here.
And make your friend behave. We got enough trouble from some of the residents, old-timers who've gone sadly to seed and lost their dignity.
How terrible. Come along now. I will keep this fellow on the straight and narrow.
Well, come back and see us sometime soon. Excuse me, gentlemen. Bo, these better be ugly rumors. Is it true you were seen talking to that wretched Penelope Braithwaite?
I can't thank you enough.
Where have you been?
Around.
And where are you staying?
I'm renting a caravan. On the edge of town, behind the church. It's horrible, but no one comes looking. The whole town is trapped in this interminable feud between the two families. His lot, Gray's, and Braithwaite's.
Interesting.
Two old plantation houses, and falling out of rebel gold, and marrying cousins, or not marrying...
Arthur, Jose, you start poking around. See what you can find out about that.
I have missed you, boys. I've heard about bounty.
Oh, there's been a price on my head for 13 years. It'll take a month to find us down here, and it seems like we can have a little sport.
Well, they're good bounties.
Where you hear this?
Some fellas I met at a camp near the state line said there was talk of it in bars in the north and west for 500 miles. There was talk of super agents or some such.
Super agents? I'd love to meet one. It's just talk.
I'm sure it is, but I could not tell you.
Stay out of trouble.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Okay, so these two plantation families. Arthur, you start sniffing around the Gray's place, see what the story is there.
Yeah, I passed by it earlier with our friend, Archibald.
Good. Hosea, you see what you can find out about these Braithwaites.
All right. Thank you, Arthur.
Quite a fishing trip.
There's still time. I'm up for it.
How about you, Arthur? Have you had enough of the chase for one day?
Sure, why not?
Great. Hosea, why don't you lead us to that spot you were talking about? I kind of like this place.
Okay. Let's see if we can avoid any more excitement.
How's it old McKinney's place this week? He raised another sagebrush crop this season.
All right, gentlemen. Follow me.
This creek.
It's a bit of a ride still, and it's not a creek. It's the same lake we camped on, just a different pipe. It'll be worth it. I saw some big drum and sturgeon there. Should be rock bass, bluegills, perch, pickerel too. It's a good spot.
We'll see if you're as good at catching fish as you are at catching criminals, Arthur.
Trelawney owes me for that.
Trelawney owes everyone for something, but his information is good.
Plus, we are now ingratiated with the local law. I'd say it was a worthwhile diversion all around.
Trelawney's like a bad penny.
I'm not sure how good a magician he is, but he's certainly good at disappearing when he feels like it.
Where does he go?
Everywhere and nowhere, it seems. We wouldn't have got Sean back if he hadn't been weaseling around down that way, though.
Hey, Dutch, remember that time you found him in the outhouse?
Oh, yeah. We hadn't seen him in weeks. We stopped in some dead-end town in the middle of nowhere. Don't even remember the name.
You and Bill were off doing something, Arthur.
So, we pick up some supplies. I go to relieve myself. Open the door, and there's Trelawney, sitting there, newspaper in hand. Mr. Vanderlyn, I say, what the hell are you doing here? And he said, I could ask you the same thing. Now, if you wouldn't mind giving me a little privacy, I ate a rotten oyster.
Hey, maybe there are actually 100 Trelawneys.
What a terrible thought.
So, you're going back to see that Sheriff Gregg?
Yeah. I don't see why not. They don't know who we are down here.
He didn't seem the sharpest of tacks. Neither did that deputy.
If he thinks we can be useful to him, he can certainly be useful to us. A little hiding in plain sight.
I feel like we're always hiding in plain sight.
But sometimes more smartly than others.
This is the spot. Down to the left there. I saw some boats around last time. Be good to get to deeper water. Yes, over there on the shore. I'm sure nobody would mind if we borrowed one of these. Come on. All right. This looks like a fine vessel.
Okay. Come on, Arthur. Let's get her in the water.
Huh? Oh. I got a good feeling about fishing here. It's supposed to be some incredible sturgeon.
Oh. Okay, here we go. Let me row. You boys are too old for real labor no more.
You're too dumb for anything else.
You're still too quick for me, old man.
I enjoy picking on children. Now take us to the deeper water and pray for good luck and stupid fish.
But what about stupid luck? Good fish.
That'll
That'll do, too. Get us a bit deeper. I think here's good.
All right. Good luck, gentlemen. You won't catch much without a rod.
Should really come here at dawn or dusk. That's when you catch the best fish. We should use a lake lure. That'll give us a much better chance of hooking something big. Like a sturgeon.
Strong with a good old worm.
Oh, worms are good for tiddlers like bluegill and rock bass, but you'd have to be real lucky to catch a sturgeon with one.
Lures it is, then. You heard the expert, Arthur. Let's bait up.
Keep the lure moving slowly on the water so it looks like a little fish just asking to be eaten. Are you trying to make your lure look like a dead fish? They won't be interested if it ain't moving.
You got something biting, Arthur.
Now reel him in, Arthur.
I think that's a bite. Got him?
That feels like a bite. Got one. Damn it, I lost him.
Beauty.
There you go.
Well done, Arthur.
They can grow a lot bigger than that. A fella told me he once saw a monster lake sturgeon near the mouth of the river, just southwest of Saint Denis. 50-pounder, he reckoned.
I would like to see that.
Ha! Got ya! Shit. Got away.
Hey, Hosea. You remember that time we sent Arthur out fishing? He came back with 3 beautiful bass.
Not this again.
I don't think I do.
Oh, yeah. You do. He was maybe 20. 21. Walked in all full of himself. We had a big feast. Toasted him all night.
This was 15 years ago.
Oh, I remember now.
Then, the next week, Arthur and I are at the market, and Fishmonger calls out, "So how did you enjoy those bass?"
Look, you can fish, or you can go drinking all day, rob someone, and buy some fish.
Fish on the line, Arthur. Something's nibbling. Good job, Arthur. There we go. I used to go fishing with this feller back in the day. Wesley, his name was. Real miserable bastard, but he loved to fish. We'd go out all the time. But one day, we were river fishing when we see a funeral procession going over the bridge, and out of the blue, Wesley stands up, takes off his hat, bows his head. Then he sits down, picks his rod back up, and carries on. Doesn't say a word. So I'm a little surprised and say, "Wesley, that was nice of you." And he replies, "Well, felt I had to. After all, I was married to her for 30 years.
Oh, there he is.
Oh, dear God. I might swim to shore.
Remember those big salmon I caught in Montana last year? We had a banquet planned that night until Copper went and scoffed a lot.
You never had control of that dog.
He had some spirit, though. Never lost the puppy in him, right to the end.
You know, I remember us saying how Blackwater was the furthest east we'd ever been. As a group, I mean.
Feels like the more we try to head west, the further east we end up.
We had all those safe spots picked out to lie low in New Austin after the ferry job.
I liked it there. still open and wild the way it should be. Somehow the desert makes you feel closer to the sky.
No point us trying to get back that way anytime soon. Pinkertons have patrols out all over tall trees and great plains. We saw when we went back for Sean.
Well, look at us now, huh? It could be worse. Plans change. That's just how life goes.
You hooked him!
Did I ever tell you my mother's buried in Blackwater?
Really? She is?
Apparently so. I only found out from an uncle of mine years later. Last I knew, she was still outside Philadelphia. I left home at 15 and didn't see her again. She and I didn't always see eye to eye. I wasn't always a very obedient child.
I can only imagine.
Still, I loved her in my own way, and she me in hers. Somehow, even from the grave, she managed to have the last laugh.
Are you bored already, Arthur?
Arthur's got a bite. Nice, you hooked him. Not bad, Arthur. Oh, Arthur's pleased with that one.
I got a bite.
I reckon we call it a day, fellas.
Already?
You ain't been chasing down outlaws.
All right. Think we got a decent haul here. Pearson will be happy. Should we head back?
We could keep the boat, not too far back to camp from here.
Good idea. Could be useful.
What about the horses?
Well, they'll find their way back.
Just follow the shore south, Arthur.
That was fun.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, boys. Now, Hosea.
Yes?
How about a song?
Okay. All right, I got one for you. I asked that gal to give me some.
I asked that gal to give me some. She says, wait until the taters is done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. Threw her on the floor and knocked off some. I wish to God I'd passed her by. I wish to God I'd passed her by. Taters got burned and so did I.
That was pretty good. But you know, what song we should be singing?
What?
Well, look at us. Three mariners.
Ah, of course.
Well, we be three poor mariners, newly come from the seas. We spend our lives in jeopardy while others live at ease. Shall we go dance this round, round, round? Shall we go dance this round, round, round? And he that is a bully boy, come pledge me on this round, 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 round. We care not for the martial men that do our states disdain, but we care for the merchantmen that do our states maintain. To them we dance this round, round, round. To them we dance this round, round, round. And he that is a bully boy, come pledge me on this ground, a ground, a ground, a ground, a ground, a ground, a ground.
Oh, bravo! Bravo! Well, you know, we should not let the folks back at camp think that we had too much fun.
Indeed not.
All right. We are gonna be okay. I know. Well, I always know. Whenever I got you two by my side, things are gonna be just fine. This place will be good for us. For now, anyway.
I hope so.
Well, I am going to take in the view.
I'll give these fish to Pearson.